Hello viewers and everyone watching this video. It's me, your teacher again, Friday Elia, a teacher of English language. And in today's video, or today's presentation, I will be taking you through the degrees of comparison. Now, since I'm alone in the studio, allow me to remove my mask so that we can proceed. Yeah, like I introduced to you, today's video I'll be taking you through the degrees of comparison. So I'll be taking you through the degrees of comparison. And this video I'll be taking you through the comparison of regular adjectives. So there are three degrees of comparison. And these are, we have the positive degree, then we have the comparative degree, and then the superlative, so these are the three degrees of comparison that I'll be taking you through. Since I'm using the whiteboard, I'll be raising an extent, I rub, and then we proceed. So we shall be looking at these degrees one by one in details. And I'll begin with the positive degree. So in this positive degree, we compare two things of the same capacity and same strength. And in most cases in this degree, we use a language structure which is as. Let me write it down here, that in this degree, we compare two things of the same capacity. Yeah, in this degree we compare two things of the same capacity. For example, shall look at this sentence here. Alex is as short as Felix. So we are saying that these two people here have the same height. In fact, if we are to compare them in terms of height, these two people have the same height. That means we are comparing them in the positive degree. And the language structure we have used here is as, to compare these two people of the same capacity in terms of height. So we shall be looking at another degree of comparison, which is a comparative degree. Let me erase this work. Those of you who are writing, I'll give you time to be writing that down. So another degree of comparison is the comparative degree. So in this comparative degree, we compare two things, but not of the same capacity, where one is superior than the other, or where one is more stronger than the other. Now, in this degree, we use a structure, a language structure, which is more than. In most cases, we use than. Let me note this down. that in this degree we compare two things where one is superior than the other. Yeah, one is stronger or it is superior than the other. And in most cases we use than. For example, let's have a sample sentence here. They say, Jacob is taller than John. So in this sentence, we are comparing Jacob and John. But in this sentence, we are able to see that Jacob is more tall than John. That is why we have added the ER on the word tall to put it into a comparative degree. Okay? Are we together there? I believe you are following. Then I'll be proceeding to another degree of comparison, which is the superlative degree. This is the third degree of comparison. I told you today I'll be taking you through these three degrees of comparison. And we began with the positive degree, we looked at the comparative degree, and now we're going to look at the superlative degree. Now, in this superlative degree, we look at three and more things, but which are of different capacities. Are we together? We look at three things which are of different capacities. Like, if we have one ball which is big, but we have another one which is bigger, and then we have the one, another one which is biggest. So this one is big, but this one is bigger, and this one is biggest. So that is what the comparative degree shows us. That we compare three and more things, but of different capacities. Unlike the comparative and the positive degree, where we compare two things. Now let's break this down for mastery and remembrance. That in the superlative degree, we compare three and more things of different capacities. We compare three and more things of different capacities. For example, you have a sample sentence. You can have a sample sentence here. That John is the shortest boy in our class. So we are saying that this John here is the shortest in the class. We can't be one or two. We are more than two, we are more than three, but we realize that John is the shortest. For him, he's shorter than everybody in this class room. Are we together? So now, let's look at a table showing all the three degrees of comparison. Remember, we are looking at comparing regular adjectives. We have the positive degree. We have the comparative degree. And then the superlative. Now, I believe you have ever seen this in your lower primary. So, we have words like big. In the comparative degree, this word big will add another G and E, R. So it will be bigger. And in the superlative degree, it will add R, I mean E, S, T. Biggest. Are we together? So we can see another word like tall. Here it will become taller, and here it will be tallest. If we have another word like short, here the comparative degree will be shorter, and the superlative degree shortest. So you can have another word like thin. Here it will be thinner, and here thinnest. Okay? So that is a table showing all the three degrees of comparison, how we compare them. I mean regular adjectives. There are others like the regular adjectives I'll be showing you, and I'll be making another video which will show the comparison of irregular adjectives. Now, you have to note this. You have to note this. And that in the comparative degree, in the comparative degree, we add this. We add ER, comma, IER, and R. Okay? We add ER, IER, and R to the verb. I mean the verb. Then, in the superlative degree, we add EST, IEST, and ST to the main verb. So this is how these two keep changing. In the comparative, we add ER, IER, and R. Then in the superlative, we add EST, IEST, and ST according to that kind of changing. Now, I'll be ending this video with an activity, and the activity will just be completing a table, completing this table of comparison. Yes, completing this table of comparison sensitively. Activity. Complete the table below correctly. Yeah, so we have the positive degree. We have the comparative degree and the superlative degree. So that is our table. Yes. shall be complete in this table correctly. We shall have words like fat. Here we have the dash, and here we have fattest. We have words like slow, and here we have slower, and here dash. We have words like dash, longer, also dash. We have words like quick. We have dash and dash. We have a dash here. Then we have, let's say, taller. Then we have a dash. So, and lastly, we have clean, dash, and dash. So, that will be the end of our today's lesson. Thank you for watching this video from the beginning up to the end. I've been your teacher, Friday.